Hello, everybody. I'm John Evans, and you're watching another episode of Mid Mod Money, the show that teaches you how to buy and sell vintage items for a profit. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning into this very special episode. And I mean that with all sincerity, because this is the week we find out who wins the TV set salt and pepper shakers from the 1960s. Wow. High stakes. Free vintage giveaway. We'll find out at the end of the episode through the miracle of the Mid Mod Money prize wheel. Totally random. 78 people commented who subscribe, and then we'll find out who wins this fabulous prize at the end. But first, I would like to get up on my soapbox. Thanks for everyone for watching these videos. We've done this for 3 years, and I love thrift store shopping. I love finding things. I collect things. That's how I got into reselling. You just can't keep everything. You find things that you don't necessarily want, but you know they have value, so you buy them, hope to sell them on eBay, flip them. Now, what I would like to point out is sometimes you get burnt out. It's easy to get burnt out thrift store shopping. Sometimes I'll go, oh, geez, I never find anything at this thrift store. Should I get, I probably won't go in, or I'll just pass it on the road. Well, this happened to me last week, Friday, I guess. I was driving to Pittsburgh, pick up my son for a weekend, and the Hidden Treasures in Rostraver, Pennsylvania, right around there. I go by there. Sometimes I stop, sometimes I don't stop. But this is a great lesson that you should always stop. Because what's the cliche? You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. So just by not going in, you're guaranteeing you're not going to find anything. So I went in there this Friday, and this whole video is about what I found in that thrift store. A fantastic haul. I'm really glad I stopped. And let's get to it. I'm shocked that I ever had the attitude of, well, I'm going to pass it by, because I found these. First thing I found were these glasses, six of them in total. Glass sets I sell very well. This is a cool cocktail glass. You don't see this shape, and I've never seen this design. And here's what I noticed. Actually, my research guy pointed it out to me. My crack research guy peeled one of the stickers off. And if you can see in the middle there, there you see it. It's a little cursive L, and that stands for Libby. And Libby made millions of 60s and 70s cocktail glasses, drink glasses, juice glasses, and there's a market for them because it's a very well-known glass manufacturer and many styles. And this one's pretty good. It's not like, you know, it's not like the best, but it's a pretty nice set of six, and they are the low ball. I think that's what they call these cocktail glasses. So you're looking at probably $30 for six of these. And I bought them for 49 cents each. You see that? 49 cents. So 30 off 49. Nice start at Hidden Treasures there. Next thing I found, yeah, same trip, same store. This awesome and metal enamel cooking pot, inside mint, outside near mint. One little flaw, but this pattern is a easy sell. I've had these in various shapes. This style, this will sell for about $22 to $24, easy, off of $5 because of that color. I mean, look at that. They don't make them, as we say, they don't make them like that anymore. Next thing I found, oh boy, I had a pile of stuff at the end of this trip. This store, I had a pile right there. And the lady goes, oh, you have really good taste. It's like, okay, I'm not the only one. This form, this is a picher. This would be purely decorative, but someone's Gam Gam went ham on this giant pitcher. Here's the thing that kills me. This is clearly hand done. No signature. I would have loved to have seen Judy or you know, Donna, some name. I like to attach a name to a project. This is 1970s, probably. I'm guessing $5.99. It's worth about $30, you know, because this is not anything that amazing, but someone would certainly pay $30 for this to have that 1960s, 70s retro look. This could be 60s. It's hard to say. That's why I prefer a name and a signature. That's how you know what you're dealing with. Next thing I found. This is pretty spectacular. This picher, orange crackle glass. Now, I think they call this amberina. Some people do. This orangey, yellowy. Look at the price. Can you see that? $5.99. This is made by Kanawha Glass. And there's no sticker on it. You just have to Google lens it. And it will come up Kanawha Glass. Kanawha Glass from Dunbar, West Virginia. I'd never heard of this company. But they've been around since the 50s. Closed down shop in the 80s. But in the 60s, they made a lot of stuff like this. This crackle glass, I would guess, purely decorative vessel. Would you call this a vessel? I guess you'd call this a vessel. But for $5.99, it's worth about $40. $40. Someone will buy this who's looking for the mid-century look. Now, the speculation is that this all probably came from one house. This is all real 60s kind of stuff. And I think the confirmation is this last piece that I found. And I'm not going to get all pretentious on you and start calling things, oh, this is a nice piece. I don't really say that. But this is a very nice piece. This next thing, the last thing I found, was this. And get this, I almost didn't buy it. I was looking at, you know, I had all this stuff, and I'm like, well, what is this? And I was trying to figure it out. It has the 60s look, mid-century modern look. And then when you turn it over, on the bottom, in the middle, it says Jasba. J-A-S-B-A, I think. And it's got a number there. So when you're looking to identify stuff, and say you don't know anything about an item, does it have a manufacturer? Does it have a number system? Does it have a signature? All these things will tell you that some care was taken and some effort in categorizing the item, signing the item, letting people know who made it. And so that was really what sold it to me, was this right there. And I was like, I'm not one to look stuff up. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Most of the time I go by instinct. I was in a hurry. So I said, yeah, put this in the thing. So after it was all, well, first of all, this was $3.99. Now, this is probably 1960s. And this particular design, that number, these go for, they sell for about $60. People, pottery collectors, Jasba pottery. This is West Germany from the 60s. So this is pretty old and, you know, it's got a good look to it. There are people who just collect pottery there, you know, so pretty nice piece. Really happy to find it. Glad I paid the $4. I spent $24 total, actually $22 after the lady, again, automatically gave me the senior citizen 10% discount, which, can I be honest, I'd rather pay the $2.40 than have you tell me that you think I look 55 years old. Can I just do that? But she didn't ask. I didn't contest. It would take longer to contest and say, no, put that 10% back on there that you automatically gave me for assuming I'm an old man. I spent $22, and when it's all said and done, through my booths, antique malls, some eBay. This will be eBay. I'm looking at $184 in one trip. One trip into a store. $184 off $22. A splendid. I came out with a big box of stuff. And you can do it too. I mean, this is a lesson to not get complacent. Always check even if it's the worst Goodwill, the worst Salvation Army, the worst whatever thrift store, the worst flea market, I never find, go, because you might, it might be your day. So let's, and today might be your day to win this. Let's talk about it. Salt and Pepper Shaker TV. One person. You only get one shot at this. Okay. I wish you all luck. Thanks for supporting the show. Here we go. Go time. George Carrasco, holy smokes. George Carrasco, you have won the Salt and Pepper Shaker television set. Boy, he's been with us for a long time subscriber. Thank you all for playing this and being part of this. And remember to hit the like button, I appreciate that. Remember to comment and keep the algorithms working. Thanks for watching. And remember, always round up.